Bishop's Banging Punch. Don't rush out of service. Fellowship with us afterwards. Again, let me hear it for Bishop's Punch. Welcome to the cathedral. God bless you and God bless yours. Happy Resurrection Sunday. And you know, this is a day for us to celebrate. And we are so grateful and thankful that you and members of your family are with us today. I am Bishop Darrell S. Brister. And you know what? I have had the privilege now of serving as the pastor of this great church called Beacon Light for now almost 31 years. Most of you, you may or may not be aware of that. But I want every one of you all right quick now, just take a deep breath and relax, and I want you to know and feel like you're in a very safe, secure zone. It's so much, man, that is going on in our world, so much that is going on in the nation. I mean, from diseases, from pandemics, to ships, bridges collapsing. It is just so much like never ever before. We're even seeing that even in the ranks of royalty, but still yet humanity. And we're praying for those members of the royal family, both King Charles as well as Princess Kate, dealing with cancer, you know, sickness, disease, heartache, pain, poverty. Doesn't matter who you are. That's why I'm so grateful and thankful that you all are here today as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Now, as you look around, I'm sure some people are still probably yet coming in. You're going to enjoy today. You're going to, first of all, feel the presence of the Lord. I'm serious, in a real, genuine, and authentic way, I bet you, before you leave this place. There's a lot of prayer, a lot of prophecy. A lot of word has gone forth right here within the confines of these four walls. And you today are going to be a member, an individual that will also be able to say at one point, I attended the Beacon Light Cathedral and I too felt and experienced the power and the presence of the Lord. Listen, the worship is going to be incredible. The praise, we don't want you to just watch. We want you to participate. You're going to enjoy it. Feel free to lift your hands and worship God. As you can hear, we got some of the baddest musicians in anywhere. They're from literally all around the world. They're not just, this is not just their hobbies. Many of them, Darrell on the drums, been a Berklee School, College of Music, and Evan and from Baltimore, Maryland. Roger, all the way from Lebanon, our music director, from the Ninth Ward. It's just a mixture of talent, ability to be able to connect and translate, even in the spiritual realm, the principles of God's word. Listen, I have a word today that is going to be very, very thought-provoking, and I think that it's going to minister to your heart. But listen, we've been praying that God will fill these seats. You're here today, but don't just be here, because it's Resurrection Sunday and Easter Sunday. Every Sunday, the seat that you're in now, claim it as yours at 9:30 a.m., you and the members of your family, because in times like these, we need to, of course, draw nigh unto the Lord, right? Now, the service is not going to be powerful. It's not going to be long. It's going to be powerful, all right? I'm not going to preach long today, but it's going to be powerful, and I want many of you, you have an opportunity to meet members that lead our ministry, because I want many of y'all to connect. I'm serious. I want you to be involved. You're going to hear our awesome praise team. They're going to be out in the vestibule to shake your hands, to connect with you. Our musicians, they're going to be out there as well. If you got a gift of music, we want you to connect with us. Some of you all who are very technically savvy, our audio and visual ministry, our virtual sanctuary, we're ministering in that space every week. Come on, I want you to lend your help, your energy. We want to broaden even our ability to touch the lives of even more people. We also have a group of individuals, we call them temple keepers. Look around. This multi-million dollar facility that the Lord has given unto us, it is excellent. In every way, the bathrooms are clean, I promise you. These individuals who love God's house and spend many hours, you can be a part of that great, great team as well. And you've already been greeted by some of the friendliest, wonderful ushers in the vestibule all around the walls. So we are a family. We are the church where the Spirit of God is motivating force, and we'd love you and your family to connect with us for real, for real, for real. All right? Y'all ready to give God glory? Y'all ready to give Him worship? You're ready to give Him praise. Now, that was the informal way. You have an opportunity right now. Take a deep breath. The next 75 minutes are going to be absolutely incredible. Let us at this time prepare to receive this formal greeting from the illustrious First Lady of our House, Lady Dr. Dionne Brister, and then after which it's going to be time to put your hands together, give God the glory and the praise. I got two words for you. The two words is He lives. He lives. He got up from the grave with all power in His hand. Come on, let's celebrate the Lord, and let us at this time receive the First Lady.
Well, good morning and happy Resurrection Sunday to all, both familiar faces and newcomers alike. Happy Resurrection. Come on, are you excited? Amen. You may be seated. On behalf of Bishop Darrell S. Brister and the leadership of our church, we extend a heartfelt welcome to each and every one of you. Today, as we come together, let us embrace the spirit of inclusivity and love that defines this special day. Whether you are a longtime member or stepping into the church for the very first time or even streaming this morning, know that you are valued and accepted here at Beacon Light. Resurrection Sunday is not just a day for those who have been walking in faith for years. The day is an invitation for everyone to witness the power and the hope of renewal. It is a reminder that new beginnings are possible no matter where you are on your spiritual journey. Maybe today's celebration reminds us all of the profound significance of Christ's resurrection, a symbol of triumph, and a symbol over darkness, a triumph over darkness, a beacon of grace and forgiveness, an eternal promise for us all. Let us rejoice together today in the message Bishop had for us of hope and redemption. Once again, welcome to each and every one of you. May this Resurrection Sunday fill your hearts and joy, your hearts and mind with joy and peace and the everlasting light of faith. Come on, let's thank God for this Resurrection Sunday this morning as we welcome Elder Shay.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Happy Resurrection Sunday. I see some of you already got
Hallelujah.
Up. Listen, you can get up. We can get
Hallelujah.
Up.
Hallelujah.
And we're here to give you glory this morning.
Hallelujah.
Say you look real good.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Tell your neighbor, I'm glad you got up. Came to worship in the house of the Lord this morning. We're going to worship Him together. Hallelujah. We're going to sing some familiar songs because we all want to participate this morning. Anybody knows that our God is greater than anything.
Hallelujah.
That's why we have the victory. Hallelujah. Come on and
Hallelujah.
Worship.
Hallelujah.
Water you turned into wine.
Hey.
Hallelujah. Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you.
Y'all know this.
There's none like you.
Say into the darkness.
In the darkness you shine. Say out of the ashes you rise. We rise. There's no.
That's it, y'all. Come on, say.
There's none like you.
Everyone.
My God is greater, say.
My God is greater.
Okay.
My God is stronger.
You are higher,
you are higher than any
other.
My God is healer.
Power.
Awesome in power.
Our God.
Our God.
Our God. this. There's no God like Jehovah. 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 There's no
God like
Jehovah. Come on, somebody say.
There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no
God like Jehovah.
Say it again. There's no. Come on, you say.
Sing with me.
How great
is our God. Oh, we'll see.
Oh, see
how great. How great. That's it, y'all. Oh. Hey, can we sing it again? Everyone say. How great.
How great.
Because of what he did on Calvary. He's alive, y'all. He's alive. Oh. Hey. Hey. Sing, you're the name above all names. Say,
you're the name.
You are.
He really is a great God. I can't hear nobody. I say He really is a great God. Hallelujah. I want everybody to open up your mouth right now and declare how good God is. Come on, declare how wonderful He is. He's a great God. He's a great God. He's a great God. Hallelujah. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Everybody just said, worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. You deserve. Somebody lift your hands and say it. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name. Everybody who love Him say it. Jesus. Come on, there's no other name under heaven. You deserve the praise. Come on, worthy is your name. That's the whole song. That's the whole song. Everybody say it. Worthy is your name. Come on, declare it now. Jesus. Come on, tell them now, you deserve it, you deserve it. Worthy is your name. Say it again, everybody, say it out of experience. Worthy is Jesus. How many of you, He know you deserve it. You know He deserves the praise. Thank you, Lord. I want our musicians to play that. And everybody in the room, those of y'all at home, begin to worship the Lord even right now. Come on, I'm not going to tell you what to say with the fruit of your lips. Come on, give Him all thanks. Go back in your mind and realize all that God has done for you. What? Everything you have, God gave it to you. With where you are, God brought you there. And where you're going, only God is going to get you there. I don't know what tomorrow holds, but I do know who holds my tomorrow. And because He lives, all of my fear is gone. Because He lives, worthy. Everybody said, Jesus. You deserve it, you deserve it, you deserve it, you deserve it. I want everybody in the room right now is spiritual. Lift your hands and give God a wave offering. Come on. You did it at Endymion. Come on. Your hands was up at the Bacchus. Come on. Lift your hands right now and extol Him. Lord, we give You a wave offering today. Come on. We wave to our risen Savior and Lord. I remember I used to go to church and couldn't lift my hands. Come on. It feels good to lift your hands this morning. Because he that the Son sets free, my Yayabasota, is free indeed. And while your hands lifted, I want you to take a deep breath and I want you to let it out. And I want you to know that God has everything handled. Everything is going to work out for you and your family. The best is still yet to come, and I believe it. I declare it even right now. I speak well of the Lord. I enlarge Him. I'll magnify Him. I'll extol Him. I'll make Him bigger than any problem. Everybody, last time, worthy, say it, worthy. Hallelujah. Listen. There's going to be a move of God in this room. Gently touch the person who's nearest you. Stay there, stay there, stay there, stay there, stay there, right there. Stay there, right there. Oh, God, right there. No, I know it's Easter, but we're believing God for a real move of His Spirit. That person that you're touching right now is a miracle. Do you hear me? That person that you're touching right now, God's hand of favor is on his life. God's hand of favor is on her life. You make sure, don't you say a bad thing about the person you're touching right now, because that's God's anointed. And the word says, touch not my anointed. And don't do my prophets any harm. You don't want to speak bad over the person you're touching now. But I want you to ask God right now, make this the best year of my sister's life. Make this the best year of my brother's life. Make this transition meaningful. Let my sister know that your hand is on her life. Let my brother be reminded that you love him in spite of it all. Come on, speak it even right now. Hallelujah. Our best days are ahead of us. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love the Lord, to those who are called according to his purpose. Somebody drop hands and shout. This is just personal. And since I have the mic, I'm gonna just go ahead on and say it. It's me personal, I ain't worried about y'all. I don't know why Jesus loves me. I don't know why he cares. I don't know why he sacrificed his life for me. But I'm glad he did. Do I have any witnesses in this room? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. And his word is true. His word is true. I bless and I thank the Lord for every one of you. Reach over and touch your neighbor right quick and tell him God is in this room. Right now, tell him God is in here. Tell him God is in this house. He's in this room. I feel him moving by his spirit even right now. And the Lord is that spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Many of you, if you're able, you don't have to feel pressured You just do how you feel. But if you desire, you can be seated in the presence of the Lord, and we're grateful and thankful for all who share with us today. Hey, this is our day where we celebrate all the prophecies of the Old Testament. Everything that God said would happen has happened. And we know that God is not like man that he should lie. Neither is he the son of man that he should repent. If God say he's going to do it, he's going to do it. And if he spoke it, he will bring it to pass. Happy resurrection to each and every one of you, to you and your precious families. We're so appreciative and thankful that the Lord has allowed us to be here still yet in the land of the living. Many of you would agree with me, every day above ground is a good day. Yes, indeed, everyone. We landed the other day in Chicago, and I missed you all last Sunday before last. And when I landed there, Bishop picked me up. He says, Bishop, how was your flight? I said, Bishop, every flight that lands is a good one. Perspective, amen, has got to be everything. And we all, of course, can always complain about what we don't have, but we ought to thank God for what it is that we do have. Amen, and we're thankful. We don't have an opportunity to do this often, but of course, I bless and thank God for all of you all who shared this morning here in the cathedral. And we did something a little bit different because we want to be very evangelistic and save as many souls as we possibly can. We made a call, and our staff was able to flip it and make it happen. So I need all of you all who are with me here in the cathedral, I need y'all to do me a favor. I need y'all to help me welcome those who are worshiping with us from around the world. We are live. Come on, we're live right now. Hallelujah, and we are thankful. Come on, from the cathedral in New Orleans, Louisiana, we are grateful. And we are thankful for those of you all who are sharing with us today from all around the world. We decided to come live, of course, here in our 10 o'clock service, and we are very, very appreciative and thankful. We want all of y'all to be what we call electronic evangelists. We want many of you all, even there in the virtual sanctuary, we want y'all to like, we want you to comment, and we want you also to share. Share your page, share the link, let someone else know, amen, that we are worshiping the Lord, many of you right there in the virtual space, and even those of us who are here in person. I thank God for so many of you, but many of you, if you're not aware, let me remind you that every Sunday, we are live at 8 o'clock, we are live at 10 o'clock, and we're also live at 6 o'clock p.m. on all of our social media outlets and platforms. And I want each and every one of you all, if you were, to please avail yourselves. Of course, our 9:30 in-person service is here 9:30 each and every Sunday. And of course, this is Resurrection Sunday, and good to see all of you. But guess what? I know this might be shocking to you. That seat you're in right now, it will actually be available next Sunday. I'm serious. If you want to sit there next Sunday, you can come right back and be there. And we want to thank God for you. And we certainly will welcome you and allow you to feel, of course, the love of God that emanates from our heart to yours. Can we take a moment right now and bless and thank God for the illustrious First Lady of our house, Lady B. God bless you. Did a great job with our intro. We bless and thank the Lord. Amen. We bless and thank God, of course, for our First Lady who had an opportunity, of course, to really welcome and thank God for all of you. And we are very appreciative. Amen. And we are very, very thankful. And then also, Family of Light, as we always do, please help me bless and thank God. First of all, the mother of our church, Mother Janie Malvo, is in the house of the Lord today. There she is, Mother Malvo. And help me thank God for all of our church mothers. Come on the second and third row. We are so appreciative. Amen. And we are thankful for every one of you. I'm telling you, there's not a moment, there's not a morning that passed by where I am not personally praying for, of course, the mothers of our church and many who are here physically with us. And I'm sure those who are watching from around the world, we are certainly praying for Mother Emily Brennan. Mother Brennan had surgery a few days ago, and we are certainly praying for her, and we're going to get to see her real soon. And then we're also praying for Mother Arsino. We're also praying for Mother Effie Banks, for those, amen, who have been. We're going to continue. The Bible says, honor your mother and your father, that your days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God has given thee. I also want to take a moment also to bless and thank God for this man of God. He's one of my best friends in the entire world, and he and my other best friend is crazy because all three of us actually share the same birthday. You all know how much I love and appreciate God for Bishop Keith Clark, and then also my dear friend and brother Mark Reeves. Me, Keith Clark, and Mark, all of our birthdays are on the same exact day. I want Mark, Lady Tanya, and my precious nieces, would y'all please stand, give God a great praise for the Reeves family. Amen. All the way from Atlanta, and we go way back. Maria and Maya, we go way back, and I bless and thank God, of course, for the Reeves family. Now, amen, the Bible says, judge not, lest you be judged, for with the same measure you judge, it's going to be measured back to you. Why are you saying all that? Y'all, don't judge me on this. Don't judge me on this. I'm the pastor here. I've got the mic in my hand, and anybody who disagrees, that's on you. I want to thank God for our quarterback, for our quarterback who's here. Let's thank God for Jameis Winston. He's our quarterback. Amen. Now, you can take that high. He's our quarterback. Now my flesh done got acted up. I want to have a meeting with Mickey Loomis. I'm just playing. Don't take it that. And let's also bless and thank God for his precious wife, Breon. We honor and thank God. Breon, we love you. And Jameis' sons and all. I ask all of you all, please, if you would, we're going to have service. We're going to be out of service real soon. I'm thankful for many of you all who haven't been to service in a while. We don't want to rush you off. Amen. I want you to come back, of course. So I'm going to make sure we're out of here by 4:30. And some of y'all say, Bishop, you'll be here by yourself, huh, 4:30. But I am very appreciative and thankful. Listen, the Lord told us to build community. And I'm going to ask each and every one of you immediately after service is over, don't rush off, please, you all. We're going to go right outside. We've got some food. We got some fellowship. We got some barbecue burgers. We got the grill going. You'll start smelling it by the end of service. And then I want many of y'all also to get an opportunity. We're going to have to see how this is going to go because we got some wages that are at stake to see what is the best, Lady B's lemonade or Bishop's punch. All right, and we're going to kind of just see how this is going to go. I want all of you all, we've got some wonderful takeaways. We've got a beacon light cup. I want all of you all to get your own cup, all right? And we're going to put some ice in it. You can get your lemonade or you can get your punch. The musicians, they decided to mix it together. I don't know. They are mixers. You got to understand that. That's what they do anyway. So we're thankful for that. I want all of y'all to have an opportunity. And then many of you all, let's connect. Let's glue together our music ministry. We're going to be bringing forth, of course, our choir, our audio and video. You see what we're doing in the technical spaces. Our temple keepers. We've got dedicated people who clean the sanctuary, clean the cathedral free of charge. I mean, it's ministry. And we want all of you all, of course. Beacon Light, of course, is a large church, but we don't want you to get lost. We want to build community, and we want each of you, amen, to be a part. Now, prayerfully and reverently, let's all prepare to give unto the Lord, because it is in and through our giving that we shall be blessed. And for many of you all who are with us for the first time, let me show you how easy it is for us to be able to give, and what a blessing it is when we give unto the Lord according to the way he has blessed us, the willing and the obedient. praise the Lord, shall eat the good of the land. Let me see by a show of hands, how many of you know what God has for you is for you? Amen. And I know that many of you today, I don't want anything that's not supposed to be mine. I don't want somebody else's blessing. Amen. I only want the blessing that is supposed to, amen, be mine. So I'm going to ask each and every one of you, let me show you how easy it is. Number one, if you want to give by way of text, do me a favor, take out your cell phone right now, and you can text BLO. Come on, some of you all are doing it right now. Text BLO to 28950, Apple or Android. This is a way in which you can give. It is very quick, it's simple, and it is also very, very secure. Some of you are doing it. You do that every Sunday. You can give by way of text. The second option we have this morning is beaconlight.org. That is our secured website. You can always go there 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Click the online giving button, and there you can give continuously, and you can give sporadically. It doesn't have to be Sunday or Monday or Thursday when we have service. Several of our members and several friends of the ministry just go to the website, click the online giving button during the course of the week. The third option, this is so cool, is Cash App. All of us, most of you have Cash App on your cell phone already anyway. It's a great way to transfer and maneuver funds among family members, relatives, and friends. Some of you right now, you can give your tithes and your offerings using Cash App. $BeaconLight1937. And there too, you can give your tithe, your offering, your first fruit, or your one-time gift, your resurrection seed on today. And then the fourth option, all of you take note of this. Some of you, you can screenshot it. Some of you, you already know. You can always mail in your tithe right here to 1937 Mirabeau Avenue, New Orleans, Louisiana, 70122. Every week we are able to receive right here on our campus mail support tithes from around the city, the state, the nation, and sometimes even around the world. Some of our past members, some present members, still yet support. That's really my prayer, that every person near and far will be able to see the hand of the Lord on this church beacon light, and that we will support it, and that we would take care of God's house, so that he will, of course, take care of our homes. Now, because this is the in-person worship, we have not one, two, three, four, but we have a fifth option in which you are able to give your tithes and your offerings, and that is through the unified offering envelope. That's old school. Our deacons are taking their places right now. These are my guys. I'm so grateful and thankful for these men of God. I appreciate y'all, brothers. Amen. As we serve the Lord together, as we serve our families, and now as we serve the people of God. Our deacons are standing tall, looking good. I see you all this morning. God bless each and every one of you. Those of you today, if you are in need of a unified offering envelope, I'm going to ask wherever you are in whatever section, just raise your hand and raise it high, and I promise you one of our hardworking, faithful, and dedicated deacons are coming to each and every one of you. God bless you. Hands are raised all over the building, and we are covering every section. Those of y'all who are receiving your envelopes, please make sure that you take a moment, fill out your offering envelope. We want to know who you are, want your information. Many of you all right now, I see you're texting. Go ahead on and text your seed. Hold your phone in just one moment, because in a second, we all are going to come and bring our gifts, and we're going to lay them here on the altar as we always do. Hands are still up. Deacons, I love your energy. We're moving this morning. God bless you. Amen. Hands are raised. Hands are raised. God bless you. 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 All right, we're coming to every one of you. Beautiful. God bless you. God bless you. Now listen, family, also, our deacons also have, if you desire, they also have pastor's love offering envelopes. I appreciate and thank God for so many of you. Many of you, I've been speaking into your life for decades now. The Bible says if you receive a prophet in the name of a prophet, you will always receive a prophet's reward. Look, our deacons also have pastor's love offering envelopes. If those of you all, if you feel led of the Lord, you can receive a pastor's love offering envelope. Amen. And you can sow, of course, directly into the life of your pastor. Those of you all, and I appreciate you so much. If you desire to, you can text BLP for Beacon Light Pastor to 28950. And then, of course, my personal cash app is $BishopDSB. We allow people to do this because the Bible says if you receive a prophet in the name of a prophet, you will always, of course, receive a prophet's reward. All right, everybody, right now, we're texting. Some of us are writing. We're preparing our gifts. We're going to lift them and bring them before the Lord one more time. Let's put it in the atmosphere now. We're expecting it. Me a favor, please, if you would, look at your neighbor and say, it's a joy worshiping with you today. Hallelujah. It really is. It's an absolute joy worshiping. Hey, Beacon Light, this is a part of the service we all love. I must share with you, I love it because I know that the Bible says the willing and the obedient shall eat the good of the land. Here at Beacon Light, we do not give to be seen, but it is a blessing to be seen giving. I'm going to ask those of y'all this morning with your tithe, as well as with your offerings, we're going to come and bring them. And we're going to lay them here at the altar because the Bible says, bring all the tithe into the storehouse. I want many of y'all who are giving technically, if you're using your cell phone, I want you to come and tap the altar with your cell phone, your iPad, whatever technical device it is. Do me a favor now because there's a blessing in this. Don't send your offering. Don't send your tithe. Don't tell somebody, take this up for me. No, come and do it yourself. And you watch and see this week, God is going to bless each and every one of you. All right? It's not equal giving. It's equal sacrifice. We don't give to be seen, but it is a blessing to be seen giving. I'm going to start praying, and when I start praying, I want the people of God who are thankful to begin to come from every section in every way. Let's have a traffic jam in church because we know where our blessings come from. Every person, y'all ready? Let's do it now. Father, you said in your word in 3 John verse 3 that you wish above all things that we would prosper and be in health even as our souls prosper. I speak your blessings to rest upon these, your people, in the name of Jesus on this Resurrection Sunday. I declare, God, and I decree that we will lack and we will want for nothing. I pray that you will bless these homes. I pray that you will bless these families. I pray that you will bless these marriages in the mighty name of Jesus. In every area we pray, in Jesus' name, amen, 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 amen. Everybody, put your hands together. Let's give him praise as we are giving this morning. Thank you, Lord God. Everybody put your hands together if you know God will do it.
Jesus will.
Jesus will.
I know he will.
I know he will.
He said he will.
He said he will.
He'll fight my battle.
He'll fight my battle.
If I
can stand.
If I can stand.
If I can stand.
I know that he will. Know that he will.
Come on, y'all say it. Say, I know.
God, a hand clap of praise. If you know God is going to do it, I say, if you know God is going to do it, somebody say, I know he will. Say it again, I know he will. Hallelujah. If you have the faith, then of course God, he has the power. I want each of you all, just for a moment now, I want every one of you all to view the screens, after which we're going to go, of course, into the inner courts and share the word of the Lord. I want everybody to say these two words with me. Everyone say the two words, he lives.
I saw Jesus crucified. I spoke to him as he died. I saw him in his struggle. I watched as he breathed his last breath, and when he stopped breathing, I lost my breath too. The one who walked on water is no more. The one who fed 5,000 is now food for the worms. And if he has been defeated, what does that mean for me? I thought that he would be the king who would rise up and rule our nation. I thought that we were the ones to bring truth and revelation, but it turns out we were wrong. I mean, maybe we imagined this all along. As I watched his body taken down from the cross, I saw my friend was gone. And he was the one who found me. How could this be? He must have gone before his time. It must have been too soon. It must have been an illusion or a dream. He can't be in a tomb. I can't come to grips with the thought that the man who claimed to be I Am was slain by the hands of men. And then she burst through the door. Our friend Mary, she said someone had taken the body of the Lord. So we ran to the tomb, only to find an empty room. And the stone was rolled away. I looked on the floor and I saw his clothes. And that's when I knew. He rose. Jesus is alive. He did walk on water. He did feed the 5,000. He did raise Lazarus from the dead and heal thousands. He did make the wine. He did talk to God. He did pray for those who put him on the cross, and he raised back to life. Just like Lazarus, except for he would never die again. Jesus took death, nails in his hands, nails in his feet, a crown of thorns on his head for you. He laid his life down and he took it back again. Jesus is alive.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. We're so grateful for the sacrifice and the resurrection this morning. Glory to God. Just worship with us. Hallelujah. As we prepare for the word. Hallelujah. You have won the victory. Say hallelujah, say
hallelujah.
You have won it all for me.
You have won it all.
everybody know he's victorious. So we're victorious. Sing it.
Hallelujah. You have won it all.
Fear is gone. Hallelujah. Because
Just one more time, say it. Times that you should praise and worship God, and those two times is when you feel like it and when you don't. It doesn't matter, it's not about feeling when it comes to worshiping the Lord. Praise and worship is to be instructional as well as inspirational. So I want some of you right now, I want you to take a moment and just love on the Lord. And I want you to lift your hands either because you've been instructed or because you understand through relationship. Lift your hands like it's a spiritual stick up, like you're under arrest to say, Lord, this is too much for me. I'm giving it to you. Every burden, every trial, every circumstance, the Bible says the lifting of our hand is as an even sacrifice. Thank you, Lord. Some of you, this is too much for you anyway. You need to give it to God. You need to give it to the Lord today. Hallelujah. You need to let God bring life back to that thing that looked like it is dead. So, Lord, as our hands are lifted before thee, you are a holy God, but you are also a compassionate Father. I praise you and thank you, Lord, for this move of your Spirit. And we thank you, oh God, for the spiritual impartation presence that is both in this cathedral as well as the virtual sanctuary. Lord, we don't have to send you anywhere because you're already there. I ask that you would just use me now for the next 10 or 15 minutes, that I would speak this word into your people, and that we will not just be hearers, but that we will be doers of your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord today. Amen. God is so good, isn't he? He really is. God is so good. He is so good. He is so good. Again, we are very appreciative and thankful for each and every one of you who share with us today, of course, in worship, as we share with those from around the world, really, celebrating the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I want to share with you all just a few moments of the word of the Lord. And then again, for those of you all who share with us in the virtual space, we appreciate you so much. But we are really looking forward to fellowshipping with so many of you who are here in the virtual space. And God has blessed us, of course, today with yet another beautiful day. How many of you are glad you're in the house of the Lord today? Amen. And I'm praying that you, each of you, you're going to have a blessed week. Amen. In the book of Hebrews, chapter number 13, Mother, Hebrews chapter 13 and verse number 8, I want to read just that one verse into your hearing today. It is actually a short but powerful verse. And I know you all didn't ask, but it happens to be my favorite verse of Scripture, if I have one. because it spoke to me back in the 80s when I was on my journey trying to discover and find God. And it speaks to me today in 2024 with the same veracity and volume. And what is that word? Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. In fact, let's all read this verse together. Let's all read this verse together. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 8. And some of y'all, you can commit this to memory. Some of y'all can learn this verse. You can memorize it this week. And then you could be deep and tell people, I know the Bible. All right, let's read Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 8 together. Ready, set, let's read. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today. One more time, let me hear you all read it. Read it.
Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And the people who love God said, amen. Amen. I want to preach and teach just for a few moments from this subject, a changeless Christ. A changeless Christ. Again, bless and thank God for so many of you who are here and for many of you who need to make your way back to church, back to the house of the Lord. This is a great day to start. We join in today, brothers and sisters, with those from around the world as we reflect upon, of course, not just the finished work of Calvary, but the fact that he got up from the grave with all power in his hand. Many of us have been made aware of the traditional experience with Jesus hanging there on the cross. But I want y'all to understand, brothers and sisters, that there's so much that happened before Jesus even made it to the cross. History lets us know that they marched Jesus down the dinky streets of Jerusalem, making him a public spectacle. They laughed at him, they scourged him, they plucked his beard. We understand that they literally made him a public humiliation. They marched him from Herod's house to Pilate's praetorium, back to Herod's house, making a joke and a mockery. For in those days, the worst of the worst was crucified on crosses. To be crucified was actually equivalent to our day of capital punishment. Jesus, now the Bible says, because it was also common in those days for that criminal or whoever it was that was to be crucified, they would carry the beam of the cross. The beam of the cross, that stretched out part, and it was pounds, very heavy. And as the Bible says, as Jesus is carrying the beam of the cross, he is marching down the Via Dolorosa. He is on his way up to Golgotha, which was the place of the skull. And the Bible says that where they crucified Jesus was up on a hill, and from a distance, it looked like a human skull. But before he could even get there to Calvary, the word says he stumbled and he fell. And it was not by accident. But out of the crowd, the Bible says a man by the name of Simon of Cyrene, he reached out and assisted Jesus to carry the cross. Oh, I need to bring attention to that, because get you a good map or start researching and you'll see that Cyrene is in the middle of Africa. This was a man of color that was used by purpose to help Jesus carry the cross. Must Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free? No, there's a cross for everyone. and there is a cross for me. Brothers and sisters, we're sitting here now, last day of March 2024. The roaring current of change is so powerful that change has overturned institutions. Change has shifted our values. Change has shriveled our roots. Change has swept through our highly industrialized society with waves of accelerated speed and unprecedented impact. The rate of change has increased so much that our imaginations can't keep up. The throttle has been pushed forward in recent years to the point that no exaggeration, no hyperbole, or no outrage can realistically describe the extent and the pace of change. A careful examination reveals that we are void of permanence. We are void of permanence. In fact, there are writers who have openly bewailed the demise of permanence. Dr. Lewis, they say that nothing is a permanent fixation anymore. Nothing is a permanent fixation. And many of you right now, that's not hard to swallow. Not when we really just kind of view and look at the world that we are presently living in. Mother, we see now that places change, events change, situations change, conditions change, affairs change, laws change, statutes change, morals change, civilizations change, actions and reactions changes, errors change, cultures change, opinions change, names change, looks change, feelings change, temperaments change, nature changes, societies change, standards of living change, dispositions change, words change, theories change, philosophies change. That's why today we have married priests and atheist ministers. Change. Methods change. Seasons change. Transportation changes. And shucks, sometimes players. Shucks, sometimes teams. You know what I'm saying, Ricky? Change. In 6000 BC, the fastest transportation that was available to man over a long distance was the camel caravan, which was averaging about 8 miles per hour. In 1600 BC, That's when the chariot was invented. The maximum speed was raised to 20 miles per hour. Nearly 3,500 years later, in England, in 1784 AD, the first mail coach began operating, averaging a speed of 10 miles per hour. That was the fastest you could go. The first locomotive was introduced in 1825, and that locomotive could muster up a speed of 13 miles per hour. And that was the fastest you were able to go. It was not until the 1800s that man reached a speed of 100 miles per hour with the help of a more advanced steam locomotive. And now they are able to go down the tracks at 100 miles per hour. 58 years later, man quadrupled that speed and he traveled 400 miles per hour in an airplane. And then by the 1960s, man was now traveling 4,000 miles per hour in rockets. And finally, men were now orbiting the Earth at the speed of 18,000 miles per hour. All of that came about because of change. Fashions change. The economy changes. Thinking changes. Concepts change. Ideas change. Devotions change. Associations change. The concept of marriage change. Relationships change. Friendships change. Opportunities change. The stock market changes. The price of gold changes. The value of silver change. Brothers and sisters, it's all about change. And many of us, if we would be honest, it's getting ready to get personal now. Many of us, if we're honest, we hunger for change. And there are many who do all they can to create change. But though we are the cause of change, it seems that many times we are unable to cope with change. When change takes place, many people will say that the future has arrived too soon. Most people want change, but basically they are uniquely unprepared to cope with change. I know you need a change, you want a change, you see a desire to change, but are you willing to change? And why do you come unglued and start losing it when you're going through changes? When the only thing in life that remains the same is change. And brothers and sisters, although we are constantly confronted with change, there's one fact that shall never change. And I just read it to you in Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 8. And in the midst of all of this stuff and all of these mindsets and all of these philosophies and all of these opinions, in the midst of all of this accelerated change that we are in, some of us, the only stability that we have in our lives is that we have a personal one-on-one relationship with Jesus Christ. And the fact that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever, that he is the only thing that does not change. We've come today, y'all, to celebrate a changeless Christ, because a changeless Christ gives you stability when stuff is coming apart all around you. I wish I had a witness in this room. He is a changeless. He's a changeless Christ. He is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Time is defined as the intervals during which events occur. Time is the interval through which change seasons. Time changes the weather. Time changes the chemical composition of the atmosphere. That's why many of us, when we woke up early this morning, went outside, it was foggy. It was humid. But as time, later on this evening, the sun will be at its brightest, the temperature will change. Time changes the weather. Time changes the atmosphere. Time changes cities. Time changes nations. Time changes the position of the earth. Time changes insights. Time changes outlooks. Time changes indoctrinations. There is no area of life that time does not grossly affect. Every area of life is affected by time. Time changes animal life. Time changes the life of a tree. Time changes grass. Time causes caterpillars to become butterflies. Time causes tadpoles to become frogs. Time causes minnows to become fish. Time causes cubs to become lions. Time causes ponies to become horses. Time changes our bodies. Time changes your stature. Time changes your taste. Time changes your touch. Time, Elder, changes your smell.
time changes your hearing. You heard me? I say, did you hear me? That's what I said. You see? Time. Time changes your seeing. Wait. Time even radically affected Jesus. It was time that made him be born in Bethlehem. It was time that caused him to move from place to place. It was time, although he was God in the flesh, it was also time that caused Jesus to eat, to get tired, to sleep, and to grow weary. Time. But notice, brothers and sisters, as we get ready for our burgers and bishop's punch, as we get, notice now, the writer of Hebrews did not refer to the risen Savior or Jesus, but rather he makes reference to Jesus Christ. Wait, I'm gonna say it again. The writer, no one really knows who the author of the book of Hebrews is. A lot of people attribute it to the Apostle Paul because it sounds like Paul's style of writing. But the writer of the Hebrews, of the book of Hebrews, didn't refer to the risen Savior of Christ, of Jesus, but Jesus Christ. The suggestion is that he is depicting one who is independent of space and time. That's why he says Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. What he's saying, Vanessa, is when it comes to the divine Christ, not the human Jesus, but the divine Christ, time has no effect on him, not on the divine Christ. Time only affected the human Jesus. Christ antedates time. Jesus Christ supersedes time. Jesus Christ transcends time. Time does not alter or fluctuate the person or the being of Jesus Christ. Time affects and causes everything else to fluctuate. But you got to understand, time does not whiten the hair of Christ. Time does not affect the eyesight of Christ to grow dim. No, the psalmist says he's from everlasting to everlasting. He is the author and he is the finisher. His being spans two eternities, but time does not age Christ. He is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Go back in your history book and you can't find hardly anything that was 200 years ago the way that it is now. But there's something you can register. And you know what that is? Big Mama's testimony. You can get a person who walked with the Lord 100 years ago, and they will let you know that even through the time of slavery, even when they was out in the fields, they used to say, up over my head, I hear music. There must be a God somewhere. And then let's travel on down through the 60s with racial prejudice and all of this injustice that we receive. But even when people was being hosed with hose pipes and being told that you gotta go to the back of the bus, there were still people who was confessing the Lord will make a way somehow. And now here it is in 2024. With all the technical ability, there are still some of us in this room who confess that Jesus Christ is still the same. Hallelujah. He's still the same. He has the same power today that he had back then. The Bible says he is a changeless Christ. Everything else is changing. But I know somebody today, you've got to be glad that God does not change. You'll have some people who will tell you, I will be with you through the thick and the thin. But when it got thick, they got thin. Do I have a witness here? But wait a minute, what about Jesus? When you needed him the most, he's always been there for you. Do I have a witness in the room? That's why the Bible says that the scriptures had to be fulfilled. They had to allow the prophecies that was prophesied from Genesis all the way up to the book of Jude. It had to happen just like Jesus said it would happen. Do I have a witness in the room? And I told many of you, we celebrate the fact that he got up from the grave with all power in his hand. But I need somebody to know today that that is not just a nursery rhyme, that that's not just a story that is told, but it really did happen. Do I have a witness in the room that Jesus hung on the cross for my sins and for your sins? And my brothers and sisters, I think sometimes we give the devil too much credit. We always talking about what the devil is doing. We're always talking about the power the devil has. But I want to let you know, the devil don't have all that power. In fact, he's got some power, but he has limited power. Do I have a witness? I want y'all to know today that the Bible says that when they crucified the Lord Jesus, that if they would have known what they were doing, they would have never crucified the Lord Jesus. But guess what they did? They crucified him. And when they crucified him, all God was doing was allowing you and I to be set free from the acts of Jesus, because the Bible said they hung him, they put him on the cross, they laid the cross down, but then they stretched out his arms. They took one arm and drove a nail in it. They took the other arm and drove a nail in it. And what they should have done is they should have crucified him with his arms down to his side. But when they opened his arms, I heard Jesus saying, come unto me, all ye that weary and of a heavy laden, and I will give you rest. But wait a minute, that's not all they did. They are so dumb. When they crucified Jesus, they should have left him laying on the ground, but they didn't leave him. The Bible said they lifted up the cross and stuck it down in the hole. But when they was lifting him up, I could hear Jesus saying, and if I be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men unto me. Shake your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, tell him I'm so glad he went to the cross for my sins. Tell him I'm so glad he died for all of my sins. Didn't he die? I said he died. But early on Sunday morning, he got up from the grave with all power is in his hand. Time is filled with swift transition, none on earth unmoved can stand. Build your hopes on things eternal and hold to God's unchanging hand. Somebody lift your hands. We're getting ready to go in just a moment. Trust in Him who will not leave you. Whatsoever years may bring, if by earthly friends forsaken, still more closely to Him cling. Hold to God's unchanging hand. He's a changeless Christ. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He was grandmother's God. He was big mama's God. He was the generation before us God. And if He delays His coming, the generation after us, He will still be God. I want every one of you right now, there's no unnecessary movement or walking right now. I want every one of you in this room, if you're able, I want all eyes on this preacher right here. This was a very basic message today. The Lord told me to simply remind you in an incremental way that the only thing that remains the same in life is change. Problem is, when change shows up and you're not prepared, we're seeing even right now, poverty, sickness, distress, adversity, doesn't matter who you are. King Charles, one of the richest men in the world now, of course, but with all the riches that King Charles has, all of his money can't pay for the radiation or the chemotherapy. Princess Kate, doesn't matter who you are, sickness, poverty, heartache, disease, betrayal, change is going to make its way to you. Don't fight it. Embrace it. Somebody lift your hands right now and say, yes, Lord. Because you know God is speaking to you right now. 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 Some of you say, tell the Lord yes again. He's speaking to you right now. The Lord says, stop trying to fight it. You're not big enough to fight change. Change will run you over. Change will have you standing looking silly. Don't miss the season. Don't miss your exit. Everything that happens in my life and everything that happened in your life, y'all hear me now, God is moving. If God didn't order it, He allowed it. Everything that is happening in your life right now, I'm going to say it again. If God didn't order it, He allowed it. And if He allowed it, it's because He knows what's best for you and your future is secure. I'm getting ready to pray. This is the whole purpose of the Resurrection Sunday celebration. Many of you who are in this room right now, everybody's looking at this preacher. Many of you who are in this room right now, God has been knocking at the door of your heart and you know it. As much as you would love for things in your life to remain the same, look like every week, here comes another wave of change. Every month, here comes a new wave of change. Every year is a new wave of change. Because the only thing in life that remains the same is change. So what's going to assure you in the uncertainty of the future is holding to God's unchanging hand. That's what you got to do. That's what you got to do. There are several of you in this room right now, and many of you all who are watching me from around the world. We're getting ready to go in just one second. But the Spirit of the Lord is moving in this room, and even with where you are now, I want several of you in this room who says, Bishop Brister, if you were not preaching to no one else, you were preaching to me today, man of God. I've been going through so many changes, and I know that God brought me here today because I need to get some things straight. And the first thing I need to do is I need to get my relationship with God right. I need to get it back intact. I'm talking to those of y'all who strayed away from the Lord, and you know that right now on this Resurrection Sunday, this is the time for you to say, wait a minute, God's been too good to me. I got to put God where he's supposed to be, and that is first in my life. Send a man, send a woman, send a boy, or send a girl. I want to let you know God loves you big time. He don't just like you, he loves you. He loves you. In fact, listen, watch this, and I'm going to do this in three phases. I want every sinner in this room, I want every one of you who says, Bishop, I need to be saved, and I know it. I know I'm not here by accident. I heard this word, and I know that God is speaking to me. Send a man, send a woman, send a boy, or send a girl. Do me a favor. I want you to grab your belongings real quickly. Make your way to the nearest aisle. Come stand right here before me, and don't you worry about what people are going to think or say. I want you to move out right now. Says, Bishop, I know you were talking to me, sir. Grab your purse. Get your belongings right now. Come to the altar. I want to pray for you, and I want you to come. I want you to come real close. Bishop, you want me to get up and come in front of all of these people? Yes, because when you start walking this way, guess what we're going to do? We're going to clap and we're going to rejoice. Why? Because we know it's the best decision that you could make. I'm not going to stop until every one of you in this room who says, wait a minute, Bishop, I get it. I'm going through some changes. Change is all over me. My God, I need a relationship with God. I don't know this church thing. I'm not sure how all of this to go. But I do know one thing. I know I love God. And I know that God is talking to me. And God is speaking to my heart right now. Now listen, while these are coming to the altar, there are others in this room right now. If you've strayed away from the Lord, in church, I need everybody praying. If you've strayed away from the Lord, maybe you don't read your Bible like you know you should. You don't attend church like you know you should, virtually or in person. You are out of fellowship. And God wants you to come on back home. He will restore the joy that you once knew. I told you, he's not just putting up with you. He loves you. And I want those of y'all who says, Bishop, since you put it that way, that's me. I was saved. I had a relationship with the Lord. But I need to come back. I need my relationship restored. For those of y'all, I want you to come. That's it. Come on back home to God. Come on to the altar. Meet me at the altar. And God is going to. He's going to restore your relationship. He's going to restore your relationship. He's going to restore your relationship. Now, there are many who are here at the altar. There are some of you all who are watching me even there at home. I always say we don't have to send God anywhere. God is right there. He's omnipresent. He's omnipresent. So I want those of y'all even here in the sanctuary as well around the world. I want everybody, and it's okay, it's not sacrilegious. Take out your cell phone right now if you can get your hands on it. And I want those of y'all right now that God is dealing with your heart, whether you're here in the cathedral or you're there at home. And I want you, come on, I said take your cell phone, and I want you to text BL Connect. BLCONNECT. BL Connect. Text BL Connect to 28950. Right? That's it. Text that to BL Connect. Text BL Connect to 28950. Listen, I want many of you also. Several of you right now, get your cell phone in your hand. Get your cell phone. And I want many of y'all who do not have the Beacon Life app, go to the app store right now. Go to the app store on your cell phone and type in Beacon Light. That's it. Do it right now. Type in Beacon Light. That is our premium app, which will allow you to stay connected with our ministry. It will allow you to stream the services live. It'll allow you to receive all of our I Commit daily text messages. We want you to do that. I want you to do that. And then I want you to share it with other people. Things change. We don't now have to call somebody to come to the church. We can bring the church to them. Things change, methods change, philosophies change. So I want many of you, as we stay connected through the Beacon Light app, several of you right now, you can scan the QR code. And as you scan the QR code, I want you to get that form. We're going to connect with you. Everybody whose information we have, our ushers now also have some connect cards to literally get your information. We want your name. We want your email address. We want to connect with you. Raise your hand right where you are, and we've got some workers there in the aisle. Just raise your hand and we'll give you a card. We want to get your information. You've got a skill. You've got a talent. You have an ability. Why don't you bring that to the kingdom of God? There's another hand there, and these who are here at the altar. Listen, those of y'all who stand before me, I want y'all to stand for a moment. I want to bless and thank God. Look, church, I want everybody to give God a great praise for all of these who stand. Come on, give God praise like this is your cousin, like this is your nephew. Thank you, God. We got a card for everyone. I want y'all to fill that out. Listen, everybody, right quick. We're going to give you a pen. Just take a moment. I want you to fill out your name. Fill out your email address if you have one. Give us your phone number. Give us the real number, not the fake one. No. If you got a real, give us your number. We want to connect with you because I know many of you all have gifts. You have talents. And some of us, even who are in church right now, you can feel that, you know what? This is where I need to be on Sundays. This is where I need to be on Sundays. Thank you, Lord. This is a great environment for us to grow and for many of us to even connect. And we thank God for every one of these who are here. We're going to get these calls in just a moment. No one leave yet. We're getting ready to go in a second. We bless and thank God. God says, "And my house shall be called a house of prayer for all people." For many of you, for these young people, we're excited for you. We're going to be relaunching our youth ministry. We have some real fun, cool things to do over this summer. Amen. We're going to take some field trips together and do some wonderful things. And I appreciate the patience of all of you today. Amen. And we're going to get that information. Many of you, you've had an opportunity also to scan the QR code. And then many of you all have already texted BL Connect to 28950. And for each of you, we appreciate each of you so much. Once you have your card filled out with most of the information, you can just lay it there right there on the altar. We'll pick it up, we'll get it, and we're going to ensure. But what we're going to do is we're going to close out in a moment of prayer, and we're going to bless everyone. Thank you. God bless 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 you. Let me see by a show of hands, how many of you says, "Bishop, lately I've been going through some changes." How many of you? Wave at me if you've been going through changes. Don't fight it. Don't fight it. Right? Don't fight it. I told you, everything in life changes. Everything changes. Everything changes. And there's no way that you can fight the change. You can fight it all you want, but you're going to lose. Right? Seasons come and seasons go. And I'm grateful and I'm thankful for every one of you. Now listen right now. I want those of y'all who come forward, I want y'all to bow your heads. I want to have a word of prayer with you. And the body of Christ is going to be in agreement. And no one move. I'm going to give us some final instructions. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, we bless you and thank you for these who are standing here. Lord, some of them are standing for one thing. Others are standing for something else. But whatever the need is, Lord, we pray that you would meet the need now in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless that one, God, today who is accepting you as Lord and Savior for the very first time. I pray, God, that you would write their names in the Lamb's Book of Life, never ever to depart again. Thank you, Lord, for those who've strayed away, but today they're coming back home unto you. Lord, restore the joy that they once knew. And last but not least, for that one who's accepting you as Lord and Savior for the very first time.
for those of y'all who stand before me, listen to this. I want every one of you all to repeat this prayer after me. And the body of Christ is going to be in agreement. I don't want y'all to just say words, but I want you to repeat this prayer after me, and I want you to mean it. Say this prayer with me. Say, dear Lord, in the name of Jesus, say, I come, Lord, asking that you will forgive me of all of my sins. Say, come into my heart, create in me a clean heart, and renew a right spirit within me. Say, I will serve you the rest of my days. I claim the victory. Say, and I believe I am saved. Say, I am saved. Say, I am saved. Give God a great hand clap of praise. That's what it's in. Listen, y'all, hold up. For those of y'all who are still at home, from all around the nation, around the world, doesn't matter what time zone it is, I want many of you right now to call that number on the screen, 504-324-8787. Please call that number, and I promise you we've got a dedicated, faithful intercessor who is going to call you back right away. And whatever your prayer request is, we are going to bring that request before the Lord. We've got some people who give themselves all during the course of the week to pray for those who connect with our ministry. So I want many of you all to do that today. The Bible says, for with the heart, man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth, confession is always made unto salvation. So we bless and thank God. I've got everybody's card. Y'all gave me the real number, the real one. I'm gonna check it right quick. All right, so we're thankful for that. Now listen, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna allow these to go back to their seat because there's another group who's gonna come to the altar right quick, and then we all are getting ready to be dismissed. So I wanna bless and thank God. Don't get lost in the crowd. As you go back to your seat, go back to your seat, because I wanna see where you're sitting at, because I'm gonna be looking for you next Sunday. Go back to your seat. I'm gonna see where you're sitting at. Give them a great praise, y'all. Come on, y'all. Yes, indeed. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise for them. I'm grateful and I'm thankful for that. Now, listen, I am so thankful and I'm so appreciative. We're going to build community and we're going to fellowship in just one moment. But this is what I want asked right now. I want all of our children, those of you all who are here today, one of the things, one of our prized possessions that we absolutely love and thank God for is our Eagle's Nest. We take great, 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 great pride in and with our Eagle's Nest. Minister Linda Gaspard is standing right here on the side, because what we want to do very orderly is we're going to usher and transport our entire overall fellowship. Now listen to this. I need all of our children today who need some school supplies. You need free school supplies. If it's a loose leaf paper, if it's a color, whatever it is, if you need some school supplies, stand up, please, wherever you are. If you're in kindergarten, first grade, second grade, you need school supplies, come up right quick. Come on up to the altar. We got some school supplies for you, and you're going to be able to get whatever it is you need. Come on. Come on. Whatever it is that you need, pencils, eraser, anybody who needs school supplies, come on. Come on. That's right. Good. That's it. Good. Come on. You need some school supplies. We're going to, come on real quickly, all right? Now listen, if one of these your child, please come to the altar right quick, get your belongings. What Minister Gaspard is going to do is Minister Gaspard is going to take this group up real quickly. They're going to go to the Eagle's Nest. They're going to get all the school supplies they need. And then we want y'all, when you go upstairs and get your school supplies, we want y'all to meet us out front in about 6 minutes. In about 6 minutes. All right? All of y'all turn, follow Minister Gaspard. You're going to go and get your school supplies or everything you need. Get it from the Eagle's Nest. Come on, church, give God praise. This is what God has called us to do. We're going to make sure we're going to save some punch. We're going to save some lemonade for you. We're going to save some burgers for you. We're going to save it. Praise the Lord. Thank you, parents. We got y'all covered. Just go up to the Eagle's Nest right quick. Let them get whatever it is, God bless you, that is needed. Beautiful. Beautiful, 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 beautiful.
All right, we're going to build community in just a moment, y'all. You're going to be able to smell the burgers. The grill is already going. We're going to do that in just a second. But before we get out of here, thank you, Lord God. I know y'all probably was hoping that I would. I don't know if you was wondering if I was or not, but I am certainly going to do it, and I'm grateful. Jameis, God bless you, man. We love you. Come on, family. Come on, family. Come on, family. Come on, fam. Come on, fam.
Glory to God, hallelujah, how we doing? Yes. Happy Easter, happy Resurrection Sunday. Yes. Me too, y'all, I'm just like you. I'm so grateful that the Lord sent his only begotten son to sacrifice his life to wash us all free. His blood washed us all free of our sins. So glory to God. Let us just continue to give him the glory. Thank you, Bishop, for the amazing word that you have given us today. I just want to continue to encourage everyone out there right now. Like Bishop said earlier, that spot that you're sitting in right there is going to be here next Sunday, because we got to continue to lift up our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, because what he did for us, we cannot compete. But the great thing it is, we don't have to do too much. We don't have to worry about what we did in the past. Everything that he has done on this day, he has risen again to wash us free. For everything that we did, we don't have to be perfect, okay? He has already paid the price for us. That is our salvation. That is why we are able to claim him as our Lord and Savior today. So I just want to say thank y'all, everybody out there. Let's give Pastor Brister and Mama Bia another round of applause. Thank you for my wife. God bless y'all. And y'all enjoy y'all Easter Sunday. All right.
Jameis Winston, come on, y'all, give it up for him one more time. I'm going to ask real quickly. We're going to shift all this. I'm going to ask Jameis and Breon, would you all please, we're going to release everyone 5 minutes. I want you all to be, how about if you and your wife would be this morning our celebrity taste judge between the lemonade and the punch? we're gonna do that. And, because we want somebody who's impartial. Where's Lady B? Somebody, okay. We want somebody to be impartial. So listen, in just a second here, we're going to release. Our kids are getting their supplies right now in the Eagle's Nest. They'll be walking around. They're going to meet us up front there in the campus. Now, we've got a lot of guests here today, and I want all the family members, of course, let's ensure that our guests get the burgers first and the lemonade first. And look how y'all looking at me. Y'all got that Seven Ward look like. All right, we're gonna allow our guests. But listen, we've got some great giveaways out front. Members of our worship team, our musicians, many of the people that you see serving tirelessly each and every week. We've got four different tables there in the vestibule representing the different aspects of opportunity for you to worship and to serve the Lord with us here, of course, within our church. Great, great, great ministry opportunities for us all. So I'm going to ask every one of you, don't rush straight to your car. Shake somebody's hands. We've got several giveaways. Some of them are educational. Some of them are health driven. We've got some books. We've got educational stuff. We've got some candy for the kids as well for Easter. Those of y'all who are not offended of such will get an opportunity, of course, to do that. I want to thank God for my family today, and we're going to all go, because that's what this family moment is really all about. Can I ask you guys to come up real quick? Can I ask y'all to come up? We got so many new members, so y'all don't get an opportunity to see my family. Trey, please, come on, y'all, come up. This is my family. I love them all so much. Amen. And you're talking about change. Hi, Soleil. See everybody? Soleil, you see everybody? This is Soleil. This, look at D3, got his fresh Easter cut. My grandbabies, they make my day. They make my world. They make my week, and I'm just so appreciative. Lady B, I'm grateful and thankful. Look, Uncle Trey is here today, Uncle DJ. Lady Toy is here, my daughter, and I'm just so appreciative, and I'm thankful for you all who just continue to undergird, amen, and to, of course, lift us up in prayer. What? Salay, she want to sing. She want to sing. All right. So what we're going to do now, everybody, is we're going to shake hands. We're going to fellowship. We're going to go right out front. We have also the Calvary cross. We've got a cross there in the vestibule. I encourage each of you family members, won't you take a picture with members of your family there with the cross also there in the background. The resource center is open as well, and we are thankful, so we're going to get an opportunity to do all of that together. All right, y'all ready? We good? Please, if you would, stand, show your neighbor some love. Tell him I love you and there's nothing you can do about it, but love me back, love me back. Mm-hmm. Yeah, watch y'all stand. Beautiful. Looks sharp, son. All right, if you will hold your love just for one moment, hold your love just for one moment. Our praise team is going to the front. Y'all let our leaders get in place right quick. Praise team is going to the front. Y'all shake their hand, embrace them. Our musicians are going to be out there up front in just a moment. Don't rush off. I'm gonna be releasing this punch in 5 minutes. I'm gonna be at the table. 5 minutes. I'm coming with the punch. I know you're ready for it.